The Bul Armory Tomahawk now has 5 ports, turning what was a pretty awesome Glock clone into something different. The Tomahawk review starts now. Welcome back to the Humble Marksman channel. I'm David, and this is the Bul Armory Tomahawk. Now, if you're one of the real ones, you'll remember that back in like 2022, I reviewed the original Bul Armory Tomahawk, which was this one, and I still have it here. Bul Armory, who is committed to building better guns, made some pretty mega updates for the 2024 model, which is why it's being revisited on the channel. And we'll get into that, but first, I need to acknowledge the dads in the audience. You have the most important job in the world, and allow me to support you with this. My son asked me if we were pyromaniacs, and I said, yes, we arson. And before we get going, a quick note to the manual reviewer from YouTube who is no doubt watching this. This is completely stock as it shows up from the factory, with the exception of adding an optical sight, which is allowed by your rules, so don't be a dum-dum. And to my lovely viewer, if you think you're subscribed to the channel, be sure you are still subscribed, because YouTube's been unsubscribing people again. It's really fun in 2024. But also a quick shout out to my locals and Patreon supporters. You guys are awesome and really help get these kinds of videos done, and I appreciate you guys. And a final disclosure before we really get started is this is a media gun that was sent to me for review purposes. Doesn't mean we're going to pull any punches. We'll get into the negatives later. But at the same time, now you know, there's no money that's changed hands. I used all my own ammo, those kinds of things. So quickly discussing what this gun is the Axe FS Tomahawk is a full-size Glock clone, but what they kind of did with the gun is they took away all of the blockiness and weird grip angleness that is on Glock pistols and made a gun that is actually pretty pleasant to shoot. Now, for those of you who watched the 22 video, the big notable upgrades on this gun is enhanced texturing. On the old gun, this kind of basket weave pattern on the side of the gun wasn't super bitey. It actually was a little bit kind of slippery. It was great on the front and back strap, so they kept the good stuff on the front and the back strap, and they upgraded the side panels with a very, very nice texture. Now, if we were to put it on a salsa scale, I would call this like a Tostitos hot, meaning that the computer hands havers in the audience will complain about the texture, saying it's a little bit too much, and the real shooters in the crowd will be like, this is pretty good. I could probably deal with a little bit more heat, but you know, this is pretty good. Obviously, the other big addition, and this is done at the factory, YouTube, don't be weird, is they ported the barrel. Now, the slide profile on the old Tomahawk is exactly the same, and it still is on the new gun, but rather than a spiral fluted barrel, they have a straight barrel with 5 ports drilled in the top. That's cool because it allows gas to kind of vent and allows the gun to be super flat. We'll get into that in the shooting section. I was blown away. The rest of the kind of features on the gun is the magwell has this nice hook down at the bottom, and that serves 2 purposes. It allows a longer magwell front to back, which makes reloads a little bit easier, but it also has these little cuts in the side, which allow you to strip the OEM magazines, which have these little ears on it, which is kind of nice. Now, the gun does come with a range bag and 2 metal feed-lipped Glock mags as made by Bul Armory, so that's all pretty cool. The slide that they've got in this gun is one of the best kind of in the segment. It's a pretty, like, no-frills, plain Jane, and the slide is so good they actually adopted what was on the Axe Tomahawk slide, the way they did these slide cuts, onto their full line of the SAS-2, which is their like 2011 style gun. These serrations are super usable and easy to get at from any angle you try to grab them on. And the slide is direct mounted for an RMR style optic. This is a Gideon Optics Omega, which is like an SRO, but doesn't cost SRO money. Check back on the channel later for a review on that, but so far so good. The trigger is very good. Now this trigger is about The trigger is about 3.5 pounds. I was gonna say 4 pounds, but it's about 3.5 pounds. The trigger has an aluminum trigger shoe with a red trigger safety, as you can kind of see there. And the pull kind of stops right at about the 90 degree mark and then breaks and pulls past. The trigger is very broad and very wide. And honestly, the character of the trigger still has some of the Glock trigger squish. I think it's kind of unavoidable for how the Glock trigger sort of operates, but it is a very nice Glock trigger. The trigger out of the box is gonna be better than what most homebrew gumsmiths are gonna come up with, but you know, there's that. There's a couple small details I just want to highlight to you guys. The takedown levers are super aggressive so they don't slip. The guide rod is a steel guide rod, which is nice. There are these little ledges on the front. If you want to use them as like a gas pedal, you can do that, or a memory pad for your trigger finger. The slide stop is shielded. You can kind of see that little plastic wall built in there so that your support hand isn't as likely to keep the gun from going to slide lock. And the slide stop is extended so you can reach it very easily. There is a built-in beaver tail to keep you from getting filleted by the slide if you are one of the big hand havers in the audience. Now, before we get into the shooting, let's talk about the velocity loss, because you don't get to have ports on the gun unless you are losing velocity, and this gun does lose velocity. So I took AAC 124 grain, which the box says is 1150 foot per second, but in reality that sucker was pushing 1250 foot per second out of the 22 Tomahawk. Yeah, that's like NATO speeds. So the AAC 124 grain was pretty hot stuff, and out of the 24 Tomahawk it was coming in between 1150 and 1175 foot per second. That's about a 6% velocity loss. And that'll bring us into the shooting segment. And boys, this gun is a shooter. It doesn't really matter your style of shooting. This gun kind of has you covered. If you just wanna, you know, focus on going slow and printing small groups, this gun can do that. If you want to pull the trigger really fast and giggle, this gun can do that as well. Slow fire accuracy wise, this gun is one of the more accurate ones that I've shot recently, and I was very pleased with the accuracy I got out at 25 yards. I have to keep talking so you can watch this continuous cut of me shooting slow fire, only so I can walk up to the target then show you this. When I started shooting the gun fast, that's when I really, really started liking the gun. This gun is ridiculously stable, and I just want to start by showing you the side-by-side of the 22 Tomahawk with the 24 Tomahawk, because you can see just how violently the 22 Tomahawk is shooting by comparison, specifically once the slide has closed and you can see kind of those oscillations going on there. The 24 Tomahawk is just way more stable, and the added traction from the enhanced grip makes it all the better. So this son of a gun was allowing me to absolutely disrespect targets at 15 and even 20 yards. Like, as fast as I can pull the trigger, I was keeping it on the steel that I had up on the bay. As far as getting into reliability is concerned, I took it out and I shot about 250 rounds of range loads through it to test a few different types of ammo, and about 50 rounds of hollow points to check it out. Got a bunch of different hollow points to try out. We'll start with this is critical defense 115, full power. Yep. This is we'll go up to the 135 plus P critical duty. A little bit more pop in that one, but still pretty good. And then going up to the 147 subsonics. It's pretty manageable. And this is gonna be the one, if it's gonna choke on any of it, it's gonna be this is critical defense light, 115. Just a baby powder puff of a load. Let's see. Yeah, I didn't expect it honestly to feed that. So critical defense light, let's see. Maybe it's just that one off the first of the MAC. Okay. Yeah, it's just not enough powder. And I'm happy to report that the gun was basically completely reliable right out of the box. Now, I didn't oil it or clean it or anything like that. The gun came dripping in oil. We'll talk about that more in a bit. So it didn't need any encouragement from me. The range loads I shot with it were S&B 115s, the AAC 124s, and Federal Syntec 130 grain PCC ammo, which usually does well in these ported and compensated guns. Yeah, it went bolt action with critical defense light, which will go bolt action in most guns that have any sort of compensation or porting going on. Critical defense light is really only suited to short barrel guns with very light slides. So I don't fault it for that. It's still 100% reliable in my book. And that just means the operating window for the type of ammo it will tolerate, it needs some gas to run the slide, as you would expect for having ports.
That's pretty silly, dude.
All right, but it's not all sunshine and rainbows. There are some negatives associated with the gun. First and foremost, the ports will cloud up your optic. This is what my optic looked like after about 300 rounds or so on the range.
It does smoke the lens pretty good, especially with one of these kind of cantilevered forward. You can see how close the optic is to the window. But being that close to the window definitely is smoking the glass a little bit. This is probably, I don't know, 300 rounds or so.
And it's not necessarily going to look like that for you. This is one of those like forward offset lenses on this Gideon Optics here. So it's going to be a little bit worse out of this. You can see how far away the lens is from the ejection port. And that's honestly the biggest gripe I have. That is the most serious complaint that I have. So much so that you will giggle when I tell you the next complaint. This gun comes absolutely coated in oil and it stinks. Like, it really stinks. It's like they took only the bottoms of the dinosaurs that were decomposing and turned it into gun oil, and it's very slippery, but good Lord, does it stink. Beyond that, the sights that it comes with, in this instance, they're black on black. There are little like holes drilled in the sights to accept white paint, but there's no white paint, so it's not even three-dot sights, which is fine with me. They don't co-witness with the optic. They're just super basic sights, but sights is one of those things on a Glock-style pistol where you really can't win because not everybody is going to be happy with your choices, so they do that to keep the cost down. And this is a weird one, just the character of the trigger. Like, when you pull the trigger and it sits on the wall right there, when you reset it, you can see that my finger moved further to the rear. So the reset is longer than the over travel on the brake until the slide goes. And the reason that's a very minor one is you will never notice that in live fire, but you will notice it in dry fire, and it's kind of weird. And finally, the way that the grip finishes with this kind of like crazy hook or whatever, this thing is never going to be able to accept aftermarket magwells until Bull Armory probably makes one, which honestly sounds like something they do, because somebody says something like that and then they do it and then, you know, there's a thing. Quickly touching on the aftermarket, it is a Glock 17 clone, so that means it's going to fit in most of the Glock holsters and take most of the different Glock mags, which is all to the good. So you're going to have a bazillion holster choices sort of baked in day one. If you want sights, it does take the Glock sight pattern, so you're good to go. So let's talk about the price tag. The price tag is only $750. Now, the polymer Bull Armory guns, the Striker Fire series, I think is using a distribution model, so you might be able to find it on the shelves of some gun stores, but it's probably not a wide network. You're probably gonna have the best luck finding one of these on the Bull Armory website. So $750, so that's $130 more than what a Gen 5 Glock 34 MOS or 17 MOS, or I guess 47, they stopped doing 17, right? 47 MOS would cost you. And that's gonna get you access to way better traction, a way more ergonomic grip that has absolutely none of the Glock block characteristics. And it's gonna have these five ports, which makes the gun hilariously fun to shoot. Another gun that's hilariously fun to shoot, and you never watched that video, is the Bull Armory SAS-2 TAC Pro. And you can watch that video here.